pan right here. This is a field that has been no-tilled for several years. And cover crops have been planted on it. All right, and this is a field that is conventionally tilled. Every year it is this, you know, plowed up, you know, planted, you know, been different crops, you know, planted on it, but two different, you know, operations. So we're actually gonna, actually turn the water off, and I want you to watch these containers here, the containers in the back, the amount of water that's going through the soil, percolating through the soil. These containers out here is the amount of water that is leaving the field, eroding, you know, flowing out, you know, to the ditch and to the vine and everything. Right, we're simulating a rainfall event now. Watch this light over here. Watch here. A lot of this soil here is flashing up on that white board. There's anything flashing on that white board from that other pan. It's a little bit, but not as much. What is that? Why is it flashing there? That's soil that's beginning to erode away. We're going to let this run. And watch your containers. Again, these containers are the amount of water that is leaving the field. How muddy that water is. You let it sit there and you'll... A little difference here. You know, a big difference. You know, very big difference. So, you know, what can you do, you know, to keep Beth River or Washtenaw River or Vila Fusher or your water spot? What can you do, you know, leave it covered. Leave it covered.
How much fertilizer just washed down into the ditch? You know, there's our topsoil. That's our precious Beth River alluvial soil that's so rich, so fertile. It left from those drainage ditches into the rivers and out to the Gulf. Yeah. So, but now we've got to replace that. We got to go to the co-op, pay somebody, and put fertilizer back out on our fields. Or you got to go dredge the ditch.
Years ago, we took a 6-inch ring, 6 inches diameter, about 6 inches tall, drove it in the ground about 3 inches, poured a certain amount of water in there, then seconds that water went in the ground. Now somebody said, well, yeah, it's dry, it should do that. I said, okay. Poured the same amount of water in that same area again, within seconds it went in the ground. And we went over to another farm, same soil, basically the same crop, but the one that went in the ground was doing this, no-till and cover crop. The neighbor was doing this. Drove the ring in the ground, 3 hours later that water was still in that ring. 3 hours later, so you wonder, where did that water go? So think about it, if that water is not soaking in, where is it going? It's going to the Gulf. You know, it's going into the fire, the lake, the stream, you know, whatever. Now, which one of these two do you think water filtered or soaked in there your better? This one? The no-till and the cover crop? Or you think it was this one? Y'all want to see? Oh, by the way, we put the equivalent of about a half inch of rain out. Now, did it soak all the way through? What do you think, Cliff? Look at here. You can basically see where it's soaked in about an inch or so. Yes, that's wet. That's because it was wet, you know, already. Yeah, but only about an inch of the soil, you know, water went in the soil, you know, about an inch. And so that's something to think about. Think about it in July and August, June, July and August when you're trying to irrigate. Then you possibly wait a little bit longer before you have to irrigate. You know, a day here, a day there, possibly. You know, it may save you some money.
I thought you were
going to
miss that.
You did.
Now, granted, both of them are wet. Yeah, when we dug them yesterday, you know, just due to the weather. But these are the same solar textures. Thank you.
Look how wet that is.
You know, pretty well, you know, wet throughout, where that other one was about halfway. So, you know, by doing the no-till and the cover crop, yeah, there are issues that you have to work through. But by doing the no-till and the cover crops, you have more water going in the ground, less water, you know, leaving the field.